Hi, my name is Jimin Lee. I'm a faculty at the Department of Communication Sciences and Disorders at Penn State. Also, I'm a director of Speech Production Laboratory. In our lab, we try to find ways to enhance verbal communication in people with dysarthria, a type of motor speech disorders. Particularly, we have been focusing on people with dysarthria secondary to amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, ALS, also known as Lou Gehrig disease. Most people with ALS lose their speech during the progression of the disease. This speech loss impacts their quality of life significantly. The speech impairment starts with a minor symptom, but currently there is no intervention to help them use their speech as long as possible, and my research aims to develop such intervention. To do so, we studied three domains. First one is speech intelligibility. Speech intelligibility is the primary target of clinical intervention and described as the amount of information understood by listeners. This largely involves the type of speech signal speakers produce. So to improve speech intelligibility, we also study speech acoustics, which is the second domain. And to improve speech acoustics, we also study movement of articulators such as tongue and jaw. This is because speech acoustic is actually the result of the movement of our body. For people with dysarthria, movement of articulators such as tongue and jaw influences speech acoustics and intelligibility significantly. So our third domain is articulatory kinematics. By understanding the relationship among these three domains, movement, signal, and speech intelligibility, we can inform the optimal intervention to enhance verbal communication in people with dysarthria. Another important branch of research is to understand joint contribution of the speakers and listeners to speech intelligibility. With my colleagues, Dr. Olmsted and Dr. Viswanathan in our department, we are looking into how speech intelligibility can be improved based on the dynamic interaction between speakers and listeners. This model would be particularly important to help people with dysarthria secondary to degenerative disease, as it may identify ways to improve intelligibility with less burden on speakers with dysarthria. And it is more ecologically valid approach, and it may inform caregivers for more effective verbal communication with their loved ones. If you're interested in the work I described above, and if you want to talk more about it, please don't hesitate to contact me. Thank you.